The owner was having trouble getting him to jump up because he wouldn't follow a treat into the air. He will not follow this up. Up!
Hey everybody, it's Jeff Kelman of Solid Canine Training, and I want to help you eliminate bad behavior with your dog. I want to help you gain control with your dog, and I want to help you create freedom for you and your dog. Today we're going to be talking about Leonidas, who's here to get some brush up on his general obedience and actually smooth out some wrinkles he has with his task training. Courtney's going to run you through how she did all of that, because it incorporates a lot of things. It's gonna take you step by step, and it was all done with food and clicker. Courtney, why don't you talk more about like what specific issue it was and then how you started.
He wasn't jumping for it, so I had to actually walk into him and use facial pressure to get him to pop up off of his front legs.
And then you marked that.
Marked it right.
Great.
Right.
The end result is the dog is going to jump up and hit this.
Yep.
So that's the end result. But we couldn't even get the dog to actually jump up for anything. So how are you gonna like jump up to hit this if you don't even know what jump up is? Why don't you show how you actually taught that?
So he will not follow this up. So I will just say, up, good kid. I'm walking right into him, got him to just pop up off of his front paws.
Sometimes you don't know. Sometimes you don't know what's gonna get the dog to jump up. But historically though, when you walk into a dog, they could back up. Ironically, this dog jumped up.
Exactly.
So it's like, score, and you capture it. This Leonidas doesn't know why he's jumping up. Like he doesn't know you're gonna be jumping up and we're gonna actually turn that into you hitting something on the wall. Show a couple more times how you actually did it and just watch when she marks the behavior. So the marker came right when the dog jumped up. So you know, Courtney did this hundreds of times to make sure the dog absolutely knew this.
Yes.
So that's the first step. And then what did you do next?
Yes, next I had him doing it literally just right up against the wall. So I just had him go up and I fed him only on the wall.
Right.
I wanted him to target something specific. So.
And you walked into the wall as well.
I did. So I brought him basically to the wall. So be like, up. Get him to target the
ball. Yeah. So now he's doing it automatically because he already knows it, but Courtney had to bring him to the wall.
Yes.
To the wall.
Yeah, I had to get him to basically follow the treat up like he wasn't doing. And then once I got him to do that consistently, I was getting him to follow it onto the wall.
So all the dog thinks it's doing is
it
learned to jump up to get this food reward. But hey, guess what? The food reward is right here. Well, I'll just jump up over there and grab it. So that's the way the dog is thinking. The dog is not thinking, oh, two more steps and I'll be hitting that little handicap thing. The dog's not thinking that.
Yes, so the next thing I had to do was to get him to target this specifically. So having it lower helped a lot. Up. Nice, good. And I clicked and treated just for him targeting that.
And how many times did you have to re-put this back up on the
wall? Oh my God, every time. Up, nice, good. So even if he got above it or around it at first, I was still clicking and treating.
Right.
Like him getting in the general area.
Because you can clean it up.
You can refine it later,
Absolutely.
Right. And then I just went higher and higher with it because eventually it's going to be above like his nose and his head. Up. I also wasn't allowing him to jump until I gave the command.
Right. So one of the things that dogs will often do is they'll start offering behaviors. They'll start offering behaviors like, oh, that's how I get paid. It's like, no, we're going to actually do it only when you're taught to do it.
Since the owner is in a wheelchair, I moved on from there, knee on heel, to sitting. And asking for the same behavior. I would approach the wall, get right up on it as close as I could. Up! At this point, he was targeting my hand, so it just made it that much easier to just transfer it to me sitting down.
So he doesn't think that he's still hitting this side. He still thinks he's going for where your hand is.
Right.
Theoretically, wherever you put your hand,
he would jump.
That's where he's targeting.
Right. The more repetition I do of him targeting the sign, the more he's going to go for the sign.
What'd you do next?
Okay, last step is phasing out my hand signals and all of that stuff. So I would approach the button, which he is anticipating hitting already. Up. Good.
Beautiful.
Nice.
So did you see that moment of thinking? Leonidas rolled up. Leonidas looked at the wall, but didn't do anything. And then Leonidas heard the command for a split second, didn't do anything, and then did it. So I like seeing the dog think. So the dog is already now not making it an automatic thing. It's starting to now going, I actually have to have some impulse control. Wait till I'm told, and I can't just randomly be hitting buttons on walls.
So in the next step where I'm phasing out the hand signals for this command, we don't want to be so quick to help when he pauses for that moment. If he pauses when I give him the command, I'm gonna give him a moment to think it out. And if he doesn't do it, then I will help him. But if I help him too soon, he's going to rely on me to help him every single time. So every time I give him the command, he's waiting for that hand signal, waiting for the hand signal. So that needs to be faded out completely, and you need to give him a chance to actually do the behavior.
Thank you so much for watching that video. It gives you a great example of how we actually train a task or train a dog on how to do something. But if you're having the opposite problem and you're trying to get your dog to stop doing something, stop jumping, check out this video right here. You're really, really gonna enjoy it, and you're gonna see how quickly it can be done.